Thank you. Senator Breslin? Senator Dwight.
Thank you, Mr. President.
Senator Dwayne, we were just told you wanted to go last. Senator Dwayne, we yield the floor.
It was maybe 1972 or 1973. I was 17 or 18. Stonewall had happened just a few years before. And I decided to come out to my parents, religious Catholics. They were very concerned for me. What they knew or thought, believed, was that homosexuals lived sad and unhappy lives. They were discriminated against. They couldn't get married. They'd be lonely and subject to violence. They loved me and they were concerned for me, but I had decided that I was going to come out and that I was going to fight for civil rights and social justice. And though I worked at other jobs, really my activism around civil rights was the most important part of my life. And in the 1980s, when people in my community, in my neighborhood, and in other communities, in other neighborhoods, started to die of AIDS, if the surviving partner's name wasn't on the lease, they got evicted. And I remember going to legal organizations and saying, we need help. And they said, oh, no, families will never be recognized. And I said, but they're getting evicted anyway, so what do we have to lose? And the cases went up to the state's highest court, and that's how we got the Brashi decision, which was the first time that non-traditional families, as we call them, same-sex families, were recognized in New York State. And you know, I ran for the city council in 1991. I was already openly gay. I couldn't go back. I also came out about my HIV status. I did that again when I ran here in 1999, and I will always be grateful to people who allow me to represent them, knowing that civil rights and LGBT rights are part of what I am here to fight for. You know, when I first came here to the Senate, domestic partner benefits weren't offered. But you know what? I made the case for domestic partner benefits, and then they were provided to senators and Senate employees. And then here in this body, we passed hate crimes.
Senator Dwayne, excuse me, just to be consistent with Senator Diaz, I just ask you, we're trying to keep a time limit, if we just could finish up within a minute, sir.
Yes, Mr. President, but I with your indulgence, I would like also to have my voice on this very important issue today. And anyway, Republicans, Democrats alike, we passed hate crimes legislation and said that violence would not be tolerated in our state. And then 2 years after that again, both sides of the aisle, we passed SONDA. Bipartisan, the Sexual Orientation Non-Discrimination Act, and sadly we still have the challenge of passing gender, but its time will come, and I know it'll come soon. And last year, we passed Dignity for All Students, here. Again, both sides of the aisle, together, landmark legislation. And now, you know, here we are, and you know, my parents are right about some things. I did get beaten up. I did get bloodied. But I hope that on one thing, and I know now they would be fine with this, I hope that today will say that I can get married. You know,
if I could remind you, sir, I just need to be consistent with the rules, if you just could bring it to a conclusion.
Yes, Mr. President. You know, I want to thank Governor Cuomo. I want to thank him for his incredible and just truthful and strong leadership on this issue. And I want to thank Senator Skelos. And, you know, I'm one of the 29 over here, and I want to thank Senator Sampson. And I want to thank the activists and the straight supporters. And most of all, I want to thank my family, and I want to thank Lewis. You know, he was there when my brother died, my mother and my father. I was there when his brother died, when his mother and father died, and I loved his parents. My whole family loves Lewis, and I love Lewis's family. And our nieces and nephews know us only as a couple. And we are like married to them, but of course we're not. Not yet, but the exact same love, the same commitment. Look, I respect you. I know you respect me, but marriage says that we are a family. Lewis and I are a family. And marriage strengthens all families. It's going to strengthen my family and all New York families. It provides security and peace of mind. And like you, Lewis and I, in sickness and in health, marriage recognizes that love and commitment. Now I know it's, you know, it's paradoxical, you know, because my life and, you know, the lives of other New Yorkers, our lives aren't going to really change very much. Nothing is going to change about how we are, how we take care of each other and love each other, except for it will change. And I know this is a tough vote, Mr. President. I know this is a tough vote. And there are only heroes in this chamber today. There are no villains here. There are only heroes on both sides of the aisle and in both houses of this legislature. Only heroes.
Senator Wayne, can I just bring it to a close and recognize your vote as affirmative?
Yes, Mr. President. I'm asking my colleagues. I am asking my colleagues to please vote yes for all New Yorkers and to vote yes for me and Lewis.
Thank you. Thank you, Senator. Senator Dwayne will be reporting affirmative. Before we go on, there is...